Okay, we're going to move on to grabbing self-defense now. There's lots of ways you can deal with a grab, so answer the grabs first. Now, one of the first things that I always think you should do if someone grabs you is inflict a bit of pain, because once you hit the person, they'll react to that, all right? So that's got the rest of them down, trying to get these from the stress in the back. So hit him first, and then I'm going to start wrestling or do whatever. So you can try and get grabs and try and get the thumbs and all this stuff, but the trouble is with that is that you're having to finick around, and in a high panic situation, you're probably not going to remember how to do it. So I would say it's not a good idea to do it. You're probably better off just going 1, 2, 3, coming with the slaps, smacks to the head. So grabs again. If you just wanted to, just come smack straight down. So your hands, bridge hands down. This is kind of stuff that they taught the soldiers in World War II. Just come straight over the top and just smash into the face. All right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and if you're gonna let go. Okay. So that's pretty simple. Let's just move on to reverse grabs now. Now reverse grabs are something that we've just got to hope that you can try and deal with when it happens, okay? So it's going to grab you first. There is a special technique that you need to learn for this, and if you can swim, you'll be able to do it. It's a backstroke, so your hand just comes up from there and turns, all right? And that's all it is. It's very simple, very easy to remember. It's a backstroke. Even if you're not trying to do anything, just by turning, you're knocking them off your hand. Even if you use two hands, so it's grab you with two hands from there. So it's going to take both hands off. Even if it grows about the scruff of the neck, it's going to come off. Okay, it's just using this hand up and round. Okay, once we've turned in this position, there's lots of things we can do. We can come up with the knee, come up with the elbow, come up with the knee. There's lots of stuff we can do. Okay, but the initial thing is the release, is to get you out of the grab. All right. Again, a bear hug. So someone grabs you tight from behind. Again, another karate technique that we use is a stance, which is a sumo stance, which is a very low stance. But for this, if he's grabbing me nice and tight, you've got to flex up and drop. Okay, so you drop down the leg. So try again. So it's nice and tight, you can flex up and drop. So once you drop to here, you can come back with elbows and then kick, do whatever you want to do to get him off, alright? But the main thing is, again, is to create the release, the drop. Drop your weight down, nice and low, and come through there. Into that, all right? So nice simple one today. Okay, so move off from grabbing now, we're going more towards probably a, let's say a knife attack. Now if you've been attacked by a knife, I wouldn't say to defend yourself against a knife unless you've got no other option, i.e. there's nowhere to run, there's nowhere to go, you go back to the wall and you have to defend yourself against a knife. That's the only time I'd recommend that you even try to defend yourself against a knife. Okay, so Dan hasn't got a knife obviously, but we pretend that he has, so he's got a knife in his hand. So we're going to go for the worst case scenario. He's got the knife to my throat, my back's against the wall, knife to the throat. First of all, we may have covered it earlier, put your hands up, I'm submissive, I don't want any trouble. What do you want?
Money.
As soon as he talks, that's my cue to go. Okay, so we'll just go through it nice and slow. So he's got that there. My hands are up, I don't want to draw, I'm submissive, I'm giving you what you want, what do you want?
Money.
As soon as he says money, that is my cue to react. Hands just grab on the wrist, very important. From there, you need to pull away, the knife's out of the way. Okay, that's the first part. After this, you're going to have to deal with him whatever way you can. You're going to take that leg out, or just put him wherever, come over the top, just do whatever. The main thing is to get that knife from your throat. Okay, from here, we can do lots of other stuff. While it's there, we can't. Okay, so that's important. So hands up, what do you want?
Right.
Now, from the head back, straight in, smash him at the top, finish him, take the leg. Down. Yep. So you can use all these little moves. Obviously, the better you get with martial arts or karate, the more adept you will be able to deal with that situation. Alright? And the main one is, take it out of the way. Okay? Okay, so, that's a knife attack. Let's go for the usual pub swinger. Okay, so I don't want any trouble. He comes in with a big swing. That's all I'm doing, is bring the arm up. It's very simple. Nice and easy to block, nice and easy. You'll see it coming from a mile away. Okay, now once we've dealt with that, again, you'll need a little bit of martial arts know how to deal with this. Is keeping on the left, not on the shoulder, foot comes down. Okay, and that you can finish them off. So let's do that a bit faster now, so I don't want any trouble. So just start doing nice and slow for you now, so with the back leg, you can see what happens, it comes in, into there, and grab the shoulder, leg up, and down, and finish, okay? So it's all in the leg, it's coming up, you're swinging down, you're hitting at the back of their leg, right, and that's what will take them down. Okay, so we'll go for one more little technique. This time then it's going to come through with a stab to the stomach. Again, you don't want to just defend it against an arms unless you've got to. So obviously it comes through from there. From through. One, we're just stepping to the side, blocking with the hand over to the side. So, comes through, and down. Okay, so again, it's using the sweep technique. Again, you probably need to learn quite for a while to get good with sweeps. So as it comes through, onto there, I've stepped out of the way, I use my foot into his ankle, flip the ankle, he'll go down, finish him off. Alright, just do it one more time, a bit faster. Now, good. And that's the end of the self-defense.